Hey there, students and teachers, this is Mr. Levin. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a pocket sketchbook that you can use daily in your art class. First, let's start out with the materials you're going to need. Each student needs 10 sheets of 8.5 by 11 inch copy paper. You'll also need one piece of cardstock pre-cut by the teacher to 4.5 inches by 11 inches. This is a little bit thicker and will work well as the cover of your sketchbook. It also may be helpful to include an artist profile and directions page. They'll be folded and torn just like all of the other pages, but help you fill out interesting information, give them a chance to draw a mini self-portrait, and then gives them directions to refer to later as the assignment is going on. You can either create your own, or you can simply download the one off of my website. Lastly, you're going to need one piece of yarn cut roughly to 48 inches. Normally, I take a piece of blue painter's tape and lay it out on a table, already pre-cut to size, making it easier and quicker for students to cut. To begin, you start with one sheet of paper, fold it over in half, and crease it tightly using your fingernail. It's then important to open it up and then fold it again in the other direction. By opening it up and refolding it, you get a tighter crease. Then we open it back up and take a look. We have it split into four sections with two folds. The center longer line is going to be torn to help make our book. So we need to weaken it slightly by taking the fold and reversing it in the opposite direction. And again, creasing it super tight with our fingernail. This weakens our long line, allows us to place our thumb holding it down tight, and pull across, gently tearing the page all the way down. If it doesn't tear exactly perfect, it's okay. It's a handmade sketchbook and should have some imperfections. At this point, you have two sections that are already folded in this direction, which allows them to fit nicely on top of each other, starting to form our book. When you're done with all 10 sheets, you've got a nice stack of pages that you can work on front to back. After the pages are folded, you can then take your cardstock cover, simply fold it in half. Again, nice tight crease. This cover goes outside all of your pages and helps to hold them together. If you choose to add the artist profile page and the directions sheet, you simply take it and fold it exactly like the others. Don't forget to reverse the fold that you're going to tear it on, making it weaker. You want to make sure these pages are folded so that the text is on the outside. We can then take the artist profile page, slipping the directions inside, making the profile first and the direction page second. Then pull off our cover, place these two on top, replace our cover. Now we have a strong cover, profile first, directions page second. Now they're loose, so we need to do something with that yarn to hold it all together. We take our pre-cut piece of 48 inch yarn, and we fold it over in half so that the ends meet. Doubling it makes it stronger. We then place it through the center of the book, putting less at the bottom, or less at the top and more at the bottom. We then pull it and tie it in a knot at one end. Because the cover is cut slightly larger than the pages, you can really put a lot of pressure on there to bend the paper down, and that's what will hold the pages in place. You can add a second knot just for security. Students can cut off the extra if they don't like it, or leave it or do something fun with it if they do. At this point, you have a functional sketchbook. You can design an assignment for students for decorating the cover, and even filling out the artist profile with a directions page to refer to. And there's your sketchbook.